Well, hey everyone. A few weeks ago, I did a video on winter light hitter fragrances. Fragrances that we would not predict we would pull out in the winter time because they're lighter, they're fluffier, they're softer in general than some of the typical heavy hitter fragrances. We kind of needed a break from the heavy hitters. Today, I'm going back in the other direction. Some of these are heavy hitters, and some of these are just heavy in general, even though they may not hit you hard. And we're going to talk about fragrances that have a prominent note of either oud or incense of some form or fashion. Now, it's not a video educating you about oud or incense. There are different types of oud and different types of incense in fragrance. Maybe we can do that another time. I thought I would just keep it simple and share with you fragrances from my collection that give me an oud vibe or an incense vibe in case you're wanting to go back in the direction as we get into the coldest months of the year here. Deeper into January, February, and March, depending on where you are in the US or around the world, and you're looking for something in that realm of fragrances. So let's do this. Let's talk about a fragrance that features both oud and incense, and it's red tobacco from Mancera. You also get cinnamon in here, some fruits, there's sandalwood in the base, and there's vanilla. While I think this leans a little bit masculine, I wear this from time to time. Some people consider this screechy. I do not. I think it's a great fragrance both on my husband and on myself. And I do get a prominent note of oud in here. It's a really nice, it feels like a creamy oud, probably because of the other notes that are in there with it. And I really enjoy the incense in there. You get a little bit of a sort of smoky kind of thing happening in here. You also get the cinnamon in there, though, which I think is lovely. There's apple and pear at the top of this. And I just think this is a great fragrance at a great bargain, and it lasts forever. By bargain, I mean find it on like your gray market sites. Don't pay full retail for Mancera Red Tobacco. A fragrance in my collection that I really enjoy, but it's unique and it's not for everyone. It's Stash from Sarah Jessica Parker. I love this fragrance. I was so delighted when I got it because I find it to be one of the most unusual scents in my entire collection. I don't have anything else that smells like this. There's pepper and sage at the top, and you get olibanum in the base, which is frankincense basically. And it gives you this incense undertone to this that reminds you sort of like church, right? Church incense, if you ever have been in a Catholic church, when the silver, I forget what the thing is called, is swinging with church incense coming out of it. That's a little bit like this, but it also has like this smooth woodiness to it that's really hard to describe. Almost like it's wrapped around by this really filed down woody accord that just envelops you. This is a very cocooning fragrance. I just enjoy this so much. It's herbal-y, herbaceous, incense-y, woody. Yeah, it's aromatic. This is a gem. Then I have Alien Oud Magisto. This is not available anymore. I believe it is discontinued. And this does open up a little bit like that whole skanky, stinky barnyard oud. However, I find that that calms down fairly quickly, and you are left with, to me, one of the most beautiful flankers of Alien. I just enjoy it. Well, there it is. There's the foul, stinky poo-poo smell, but it's super quick, I promise. Now, I know a lot of people would rather not suffer through that to get to the rest of the fragrance. And in fact, I don't have very many fragrances in our video today that have the skanky opening oud. Most of them are smooth, lovely, very tolerable ouds. But this one, it opens kind of funky and then settles down into this really beautiful version of Alien, but even more woody. Next up is one that has one of the cutest bottles in all of my collection, Myrrh Assoluto from Valentino. One thing I really like about this fragrance is that it has some florals to balance it out. There are some yellow florals in here, including ylang ylang, but this is mostly a myrrh and leather fragrance that is wearable by women. So if you want to smell a little bit smoky, a little bit incensey, and still have a little touch of floral to round it out. Try this one. By the way, it does still lean a little bit masculine. I'm not telling you that this is feminine. And to me, I think of the bottle color as giving that away. This is not like a pretty girl fragrance at all. It's one that is wearable, I think, by ladies. Certainly men would smell fabulous in this as well. In the far opposite direction, and one that I would not recommend to ladies unless they are feeling really adventurous and don't mind a very out there fragrance, is Laudano Nero from Tiziana Terenzi. I joked around in one of my Halloween videos that this one smells like the funk of 40,000 years. Remember the end of the Thriller video from Michael Jackson? Whoo, this is some potent stuff. On initial spray, it's almost like gag worthy, and then it settles down into a pretty dark, mysterious fragrance. I want to share a few of the notes because I don't want to mess this one up. Cognac, tobacco, wormwood. You get a note of ash, you guys. Slate, incense, and oud. This is a funky, funky fragrance, and some might really like that. It does get better as it dries down. You have to be really adventurous for this one, okay? Adventurous. Just to be clear and just to be fair, even though this opens up almost intolerable, it does dry down into this really woody, incense-y, deep fragrance. Next, you have a dupe for Oud for Greatness, and that is Oud for Glory by Latafa. Very affordable. I think you can still get this in the $30 to $50 range. Versus the $300 plus version from Initio. And I've seen reviews about both. I've seen lots of comparisons. And while the Initio one is considered to be smoother overall, most people agree that this is a pretty good dupe of it. What do I get in here? I get mostly oud. Even though incense is not listed, there's patchouli, and maybe it's the patchouli that's coming across with that oud as a little bit incensey. But I get oud, I get saffron, I get a hint of smokiness and incense, and I get hints of the lavender that's in here. Is this unisex? Maybe if you're a little bit adventurous. I think this leans masculine, but ladies who like oud and incense can certainly pull off a fragrance like this. Next is a fragrance that I thought would be my signature scent when I first smelled it, because on the opening, it is just absolutely amazing. The trouble is the opening goes away within 30 minutes, and the fragrance itself doesn't last very long. So if you get this, keep it in your purse, keep it in your backpack, and reapply. And it is Tokyo Milk Dark Bulletproof. Looks like this. The bottle looks like this, and it tells you the notes right on there. You get smoked tea, coconut milk, crushed cedar, and ebony woods. This is so beautiful on the opening. It comes across to me very incensey, although there isn't an actual oud note or incense note in here. The smoked tea part comes across as both of those combined with that cedar and woods. This to me is a very incensey fragrance despite the note structure here, and is just a delightful, smoky, beautiful something or other. I just wish that the opening lasted forever. Bulletproof. Then we have a really heavy hitter of a fragrance, especially for ladies, especially in the winter or fall. Oud Ambrosi from Maison Lancome. Thanks, Joss at Joss's Fragrance Mixology, for introducing me to this beauty that I would have avoided based on the notes, because it has a lot of honey in here and oud. Honey sometimes, I mean, it just depends on the fragrance, whether I get along with it or not, but it has honey, it has rose, a heavy rose, and oud in here, and it just combines into a beautiful fragrance. If Oud Bouquet, which by the way, I'm not gonna talk about today because everyone talks about Oud Bouquet. Yes, it absolutely belongs on this list, but you know about that already. If Oud Bouquet scares you and you want something slightly more wearable, because this is a heavy one too, try Oud Ambrosi. Absolutely beautiful. Then we move to a beauty that a lot of people have mixed reviews on it. Some people love it, some people hate it. It's Gold Incense from Carolina Herrera. This has cinnamon in it, and it has definitely this, to me, a strong incense accord in it, but it's also leathery. It has Angelica, so it gives it like a slight greenness in the background to balance out the leather and the incense. I think this is a beautiful, beautiful fragrance and lasts quite a long time on me. And I don't need to tell you that these bottles are just gorgeous. This is a heavy hitter. Next is Franck Olivier's Oud Vanille, which is a beautiful, affordable option. that is, some people think smells like oud bouquet. I get a little bit of that. I think it smells a little bit more like the baby sister of Shaggoth Oud, mixed with maybe one of the Tom Ford tobacco types of fragrances, like Tobacco Vanille and Shaggoth Oud had a love child. Here you go. You get something like this. This is an affordable option that has vanilla and incense and wood. It has a rose in there, definitely a floral aspect to it, and I would say it's mostly rose. We go then to Bourgeois Lamassut Oud. This one is the one in the amber colored bottle. So I have the one in the red bottle, I have the one in the gold bottle, I have the gray one, and I have the purple one now. They're all beautiful in different ways. This one, Lamassut Oud, has oud at the top as a top note or top accord, if you will. And then it also has Gaillac wood, which gives it this woody, resinous middle and heart to it. And it also has musk to round it all out. So I do think that this is wearable by ladies, although it does lean a little bit masculine. If you don't mind that and you enjoy a resinous, oudy fragrance that has some sweetness to it, it's not completely, it's not dry. It has a little bit of creamy sweetness to it, just slightly. You might enjoy something like Lamassut Oud. If you are looking for something like By the Fireplace, which is a very smoky, woody fragrance with a vanillic base to it, but you want something a little bit sweeter, not quite as campfire-ish, you may want to try Amir Al Oud by Lataffa. I think this, so this has been compared to, of course, By the Fireplace. I just said that. But I think this has a lot of sugar in it, so it's a lot sweeter and softer, more sort of cloud-like of a presence on you than something like By the Fireplace, which settles down to me a little bit heavy. It's not super heavy as a fragrance, but as it settles down, you get a lot of the vanilla in the By the Fireplace. This one stays more on like the sweet, sugary side without being too candy-like. I wouldn't call this a candy kind of fragrance because it does have oud in it, but it doesn't have like the smokiness of By the Fireplace, is how I would describe this. And look at this huge bottle for not a lot of money. This next fragrance is not for the timid, and I think it's very masculine. So maybe consider this for someone in your life who enjoys a very masculine fragrance. It is like a nicer, more wearable version of the Laudano Nero, which opens up just rude as can be, right? This one here, it doesn't settle down. And what I mean by that is it goes a long, long, long time. It's just a softer version of that. Soft is relative here, keep that in mind. And that is Mahir Black from Lataffa. This has all the notes that we've been talking about. Let me share some of them with you. It does have incense, it has smoke, it has oud, it has leather, it has cedar, it has patchouli, it has lab denim, and it has myrrh and amber and orris. So it's got all of that going on. This is very much a powerhouse of a fragrance. This is like a rough, leathery, oody, smoky fragrance. Okay, so if you really want that, this will take
Then
you
we go
there.
to a fragrance that to me is like a softer version of Black Orchid. It gives me everything Black Orchid does, but rounder, if that makes sense, than Black Orchid, which I love. I have no issues with Black Orchid. It is a favorite fragrance of mine. We're talking about Maremma or Maremma by Tiziana Terenzi. This has a lot of notes going on. I'm not gonna share them all with you, except to say that there's oud in the middle of this, which I think gives this a beautiful depth. You get some woodiness in there. You get the faint kind of chocolate that you get. Actually, cacao is what it is in Black Orchid, like a dark chocolate kind of scent. You get some honey, some florals, there's iris, and there's angelica to give it a little bit of powderiness, lipstickiness, greenness. It's all of those things all at the same time, but all of that has an undergirding of oud that combines that all, almost like it's like a hammock that everything else sits inside of. So I could see this as a sultry evening fragrance for ladies and gentlemen. Another heavy hitter.
The next few fragrances are inspired by fragrances from the House of Alexandria Fragrances, which has become my favorite clone house so far. I'm bringing you African Magic, which is a dupe or an inspiration, inspired by rather, by African Leather from Mema. This is a lot like African Leather. It's not a dead-on dupe. I would say they're really close. If you had to put like a percentage on it, which is super hard to do, I would say somewhere in like the 80-ish percent range. If you have the funds for African Leather, go on and get that. It is a bit more impactful and just stronger to the nose. It has some oomph to it. This is a decent dupe and nice on its own and has a beautiful oud note in it that... it's actually smoother, if you will, than the one in African Leather, which really kind of punches you in the face at first. But African Magic. Next, you have Fatale de Vanille, which is a dupe for Vanille Fatale from Tom Ford. And I think this is pretty close to the Tom Ford one, close enough for my taste that I don't feel like I have to get the Tom Ford version. You get in here a great incense kind of note from the myrrh and the olibanum. There's some vanilla in here. There's leather, there's tobacco. This is like a very cigar bar type of smell. Really wonderful. I think that this performs well and I enjoy wearing this for an incensey note. Then we have a dude for a dude. Then we have a dupe for Dior Oud Isfahan and it's Oriental Leather. Have a little bit on here. This is some gorgeous, incensey, oudy, leathery amazingness. This smells so good. I do have a decant of Oud Isfahan and they are very, very close to each other in my opinion, such that I don't need to purchase the Oud Isfahan, but I might. In the meantime, I'm gonna really be enjoying this Oriental Leather. This is a masculine fragrance. In my opinion, I certainly will wear it. That doesn't scare me. It's not heavily masculine in the sense that it leans into like 80s men's cologne kind of territory, right? This is not feminine. Such a like luscious, clean leather smell with that oud, a very sort of silky oud smell. Even more masculine than that Oriental Leather is Agar Intense, which is inspired by Tom Ford's Oud Wood Intense. This smells to me exactly like the collar of a leather jacket. So it has a little bit of that skin smell in it. Maybe even, there's no sandalwood in here, but it has like a little bit of a sandalwood undertone. You get oud in here and like this leathery smell. I don't think leather's in here, but you get a leathery smell. And you also get ginger and juniper. There's something really, really sexy about Agar Intense. I really enjoy it and think it is a very close dupe to Oud Wood Intense from Tom Ford. Then I have Dark Pleasure, which is a dupe for Cafe Rose from Tom Ford. These are very similar. I would advise getting the Cafe Rose over this one. You get rose and coffee and a beautiful incense note. This, both of these are really lovely, sophisticated fragrances. Really, really wonderful for a night out on the town, especially in cold weather. I think these are great year round, but there's something about this smell in cold weather. When you're dressed up and you're in your finest gear and you're out on the town, these are really beautiful fragrances for festive special occasions. I love that the rose and the ambery touches in these fragrances give them a slight feminine lean. I feel really powerhouse femme fatale when I'm wearing Dark Pleasure or Cafe Rose from Tom Ford. And last but not least is a fragrance that is not easily worn by anybody. You have to really, really love incense to pull this fragrance off. It is Casbah by Robert Paget. Wow. I get that beautiful church incense in here. So it does have incense as a note. It also has tobacco and orris root, and I love that at the top it has angelica, pepper, and nutmeg, okay? So you do get like,
You know how when you smell incense, it's like that combination of perfect spices and herbs, if you will. It smells almost green, almost spa-like, almost fresh if you take the smokiness away from it. That's what you get in here with just the hints of smoke at the bottom, okay? It's more like what makes incense smell fresh, which people don't associate the word incense with fresh. But what I mean by that is what incense is made out of, what's added to it to give it the scent, right? Not the smoky part, but the beautiful, like green kitchen spicy something or other aromatic combination. Yeah, Kaz, you have to be an incense lover. This is not a fragrance that I would consider an easy wear. You have to like that. You have to want to smell like church incense, y'all, because that's what this is going to give you. Absolutely beautiful. One that I didn't mention, but is an honorable mention, and I'm not going to go grab the bottle, is L'Autre Oud from Maison Lancôme. Bar none, one of the most beautiful church incense, oud and rose fragrances. I know that oud and rose are done a lot across a lot of oudy fragrances, so people may be tired of hearing about that, but I think that one is a masterpiece, even though I haven't talked about it in this lineup. It does deserve
I
a
am
place.
really mad at myself that I almost forgot to include two of the most recent acquisitions that are absolutely gorgeous ouds. One is from Okja, Modern Oud, one that my husband and I both love. This is one of the classiest, most sophisticated, new, fresh leather and oud smells, but soft, really sort of a refined oud smell. There's nothing stinky, funky, intolerable about this. This is one that I would not hesitate to wear to an official like office environment and would take me straight into night with no problems. Absolutely gorgeous. And then a fragrance that should intimidate people because it is a poom poom kind of powerhouse, but it is gorgeous. It's Oud 36 Nuit from Al Haramain, which has gotten a lot of airtime from me this fall with good reason. This is like a bit more masculine version of Oud Bouquet, super long lasting and just like outrageously strong, but intoxicating. That sweetness, that like praline, rose, resinous kind of beautiful thing that draws us to Oud Bouquet is just as strong in here without being cloyingly sweet, but still super strong and pungent, powerful, knock you
So I
out.
hope you enjoyed this. Do you have any of these? Do you like them? Do you think I'm crazy for having these? Would you wear them? Do you have that sort of adventurous fragrance spirit where you're willing to try something out of the norm? Let me know. I'd be interested to hear your thoughts. Take care and have a fabulous one.